Countries around the world are buffing up their militaries. In 2024, global military spending hit over $2.7 trillion. That's nearly 10% more than in 2023. The biggest spenders are the US, China, Russia, Germany, and India. More and more of that money is going to high-tech and digital weapons. The arms race is now a tech race. So, what's changing on the battlefield? Let's break it down. First, AI. AI speeds up the so-called kill chain. That's military speak for find, track, and strike. The US Pentagon says generative AI helps with planning and strategy. But here's the twist. Big AI companies say their AI models shouldn't be used to harm people, but nearly all of them have contracts with firms supplying the military. Next in line, drones. Drones are now everywhere. They scout enemy territory, they drop bombs, they save soldiers from walking into danger. In places like Mexico and Colombia, drones are used to track drug cartels in real time. In Ukraine, cheap drones are used as DIY weapons. Soldiers attach explosives to drones bought online. Some cost under 100 euros. These drones can destroy million-dollar tanks.
The wide-scale use of drones in Ukraine is mainly due to a lack of artillery munitions. So for a while, drones were a substitute for shells.
Der Ersatz für die Artilleriegranate.
AI is taking drones to the next level. It lets multiple drones work together. This way, so-called swarms can overwhelm defense systems through sheer numbers. Autonomous drones are more accurate. Human-piloted drones hit the target about 10 to 20% of the time. With AI, a jump to 80% is possible. Normally, soldiers monitor autonomous drones, keeping a human in the loop to abort the mission if in doubt. But in a recent Ukrainian operation, a drone swarm lost contact. AI took over. They still hit 41 Russian aircraft, according to reports. Lastly, cyber war. Hackers are soldiers too. They work for governments, companies, or secret services.
Today, the industry has been professionalized with these hacker mercenaries. That has to be noted. A lot has changed in terms of what is being paid, how many people are employed, which are the key countries. The market has grown.
Here's how they fight. First, espionage. Amid escalating tensions between India and Pakistan, a group called APT-36 reportedly attacked India's government systems. APT-36 is believed to be linked to Pakistan. Their main tool? Crimson Rat, a malware designed to steal information. APT-36 sent multiple phishing emails. Once the victim clicked, they installed the malware. The hackers could then use it to take screenshots, extract files, or even execute commands on the target's device. Second, sabotage. Before Russia invaded Ukraine in 2022, hackers shut down a satellite company's communication systems. It disrupted Ukraine's military during critical moments. This was one of the first examples of cyber operations actively aiding military movements on the ground. The battlefield is changing, and it's powered by code, not just combat. The question now and in the future isn't just who has the most weapons, but who has the smartest ones. What do you think about this new kind of warfare? Let us know and see you next time.